My name is Tolu Adekuoroye and I'm a photographer. Fascinating thing about photography for me, what made me go into photography was the fact that I loved to freeze moments. I was happy about the fact that you could document the wedding, you could document somebody's burial, you could document a birthday, and you'd be able to go back and check it and see everything that happened in the event. I came to love photography. I actually did not start shooting immediately. I actually loved to see pictures of myself. I loved to go to studios. I remember when anytime I go to the studio to take pictures, I remember that when I'm supposed to get a picture out, I'll be so happy. The day I was still to come and collect a picture, I'll be happy, I'll be excited about it. And from taking pictures of myself, I started loving to take other people's pictures. I loved to see people happy. I loved to take pictures of their happy moments, their exciting moments. That is actually what brought me into photography. I remember that I went for training, and after my training, I went back home and I told my parents that I wanted to get a camera and I wanted to go into photography. My father said he was not convinced. He wanted me to work with somebody else first before he was going to get me my camera. So I remember I worked with somebody. I edited the photos. I made a photo book and I brought it to him and I showed him, this is what I did. And he was impressed and he got me my camera. That was the first thing that happened. As a female photographer, I really do not like to say female photographer. I actually like to be called a photographer. But the truth is, it is a male-dominated industry and many people look down on us. They feel that a female, we are weaker. And many times when I go to events, I see people, I meet with males and they look at me like, what are you doing here? What are you doing in this industry? Sometimes when they see me climb tables, climb places to take a good picture, they tend to look down on me and want to say be careful, something they would not say for an ordinary, for a guy who is shooting. So there's this limitation. Sometimes I talk to some clients and when they discover I'm a female, like, are you sure you're going to shoot, are you sure you're going to be able to shoot my wedding well, you're a female, who won't be tired and all that. That's just the limitations we have. And the cost of camera, the cost of our equipment, we have to buy a lot of lenses, a lot of lights, and the expenses do not finish. We keep buying, and these things are very expensive. They are not made in Nigeria. So that is the major challenge we have. My dream as a photographer is to break boundaries, to do things that are different, to make images that generations to come will look at and be amazed. People would see. I want to be able to make images that people would be able to pin down to a particular generation. I want to make images that people would understand how people lived in a particular generation, how people lived in a particular culture, how weddings were done in a particular time and all that. I just don't want to make images that would just stay and with time to not make any meaning. A particular time I was on low cut, I had to cut my hair at a particular point and I had to travel to Benue State for a wedding to shoot. And I saw somebody ask me, where is your mom? Where are you from? How old are you? So I was like, I'm not here to attend the wedding. I'm a photographer. And he was like, whoa, really? You look very young. It was kind of embarrassing because of the hair. So I had to go back to make my hair. I was looking too young. So I had to go back and start making my hair. So it was really a very, very funny moment for me. I specialize in documentary and wedding photography. The best part of it for me is weddings. I love weddings. I love how two hearts come together, people who do not know each other. It makes me believe that there's love in midst of the troubles we have everywhere. People are getting divorced and all that. I see people come together, get married, two different families, two cultures coming together. Documenting it is fun. There's a lot of fun, there's a lot of happiness. That is for me a very important part of my job. And lastly, I would say to young aspiring photographers, I would say do not give up. Honestly, to start up right now is not very easy, because starting photography now, you have to get a lot of equipment. A camera, an entry camera now is not very cheap. But I want to say that you can always work with somebody. Like I said, I started working with somebody first before I got my own camera. So you could always work with somebody, sharpen your skill, serve under somebody until you're able to get your own camera. I have had people who served under another photographer and now they serve so well that the chief photographer gave them a camera free of charge. So do not give up on your dreams, no matter how hard it may be. Just keep on with your dreams, one day it will come.